So we're going to do notes on two topics. David, excuse me. First is something called scope. So any given variable only is accessible in a certain area of your code, and that's called the scope of the variable. So for example, this code would not compile. Can any of you see why, Randy? Yeah, the I variable gets declared in the for loop. So it's great inside the for loop, but if you try to do something with I after the for loop, it says that, don't know what you're talking about. So that's why I always do my for loops with I, and I always do int I inside the declaration of the for loop, because you can do that over and over again. You don't have to think, is it okay if I use I? And you don't have to use a different variable each for loop, because they're all their own little, the scope of that variable I is that for loop. So this one, I said all that. So you could do this. You could declare I ahead of time. I mean, please don't do this for programs for me. It's just annoying, but... And then for I, and then it just says I equals zero. So we're like, hey, for kicks, we're going to have this variable I that we can access outside of the loop. And then now I'm setting it to zero, and it would work. But it's kind of weird. Why would you do that? Okay, other things to know about scope. When you declare a variable in a constructor or method, it's called a local variable. It only exists inside the constructor or the method. That's point two. Local variables can only be used right where they were created. Yes, Walker.
If you declare a variable in the main method, can it be accessed from other methods?
No. The question was, if you declare a variable in the main method, can it be accessed in other methods? And no. You can't. I mean, if you make a variable and it only exists there, you can't use it somewhere else. So. Yeah, the main method isn't special in that way where it has some special thing. Parameters in a constructor or method header can only be accessed within that method or constructor. And if you have a local variable with the same name as an instance variable, your method or constructor uses the local variable. I'm going to give you examples of all these things. So points one and two. When you declare a variable in a constructor or method, it's called a local variable. So I created this variable t, it's a local variable. And it's just so that we can have the return not say engine status true or false. It's going to say good if it was true and bad if it was false. But no other method has access to this variable t. Like you can't have a method, even if it's right next to it, say, oh, if t is good, then do this. Because T just exists. The scope of T is the two-string method. Here's something wrong with this code. Look at it for a second, and then I'd love it if someone could say what's illogical about this code. I mean, it'll run, but it's kind of pointless. Yeah, Johan. Yeah, that private Boolean is hungry. There's a couple things wrong. You can't declare private variables inside of a constructor. But I think, you can't declare variables public or private inside of a method or a constructor. I mean, another thing that's wrong is we're declaring this variable in the constructor, and then the constructor ends, and we never used the variable, and that variable doesn't exist anywhere else. It's a local variable. So I wish this said also is hungry, just got created and never got used. And what was the point of that anyway? I mean, it doesn't cause it to crash or something, but you see what we're doing? Like, oh, we're setting this Boolean variable true. And then that variable is accessible nowhere, nowhere else. So that's like saying, hey, I'm going to draw a line in the sand and nothing will happen. And here's this thing. And then, I forgot. I didn't mean to do that. Nothing happened. Here's another example. So we have a hamster class. We've got these we've got a constructor and a method inside the hamster class. Look at this, everybody. See if you can figure out what's wrong with this code. It's part of a giant hamster class. A giant hamster class. As opposed to a small hamster class. Oren.
Looks like they're using name in the second one. Oh, wait, actually, never mind.
Name's not the problem. Do you want to? Marcus.
Is hungry is declared inside of the constructor, but it needs to be declared outside of it.
Yeah, yeah. Well, is hungry is a local variable in the constructor, and so therefore it doesn't exist. You can't use it in toString. So if you want to have a variable called is hungry that's true or false, you'd need to say private boolean is hungry up top, you know, in the class. And maybe they did. Even if they did, the fact that they created that one in the constructor, that's like a local variable that does nothing. Again, it's an example of creating a variable that does absolutely nothing. Yes?
Also, it has return functions on a string. Oh, wait.
That's correct. Yeah. You can, it'll use, when you're in the method, it uses the one inside the method. It just pretends the other one doesn't exist. It's one of my points. We'll keep going. Parameters declared in a method or constructor can only be used within that method or constructor. It's missing the word header. So what's wrong with this? I see this a lot. Breaks my heart when I see you guys do this. But it's understandable. Antonio. Yeah, it's returning N. And it's easy to be thinking, oh, I know N is the name. But listen, N only exists up here in the constructor, in the constructor header and inside the constructor. So you really, the correct thing would be to say, return name here, because toString doesn't have access to n. That was only a sort of a temporary variable created locally in the constructor. So good. Finally, when there's a local variable with the same name as an instance variable, the variable name will refer to the local variable instead of the instance variable. So I've got this 0.4 class. It's got private int num. And then here's a constructor. But look at this update method. It says int num equals n. So if I run this code 0.4, I make a 0.4 with 17. I do run the update with 20. You might think, oh, it replaces 17 with 20. And then I'm printing get num. Actually, it still prints 17 because this method is totally useless. It's declaring a new local variable named num. It's putting 20 in it, and then that number stops existing, and nothing ever happened. And it has nothing to, it doesn't affect the num. That's the instance variable.
So
look at this. Instance variables are at the top. Local variables are inside of code blocks, and. Yeah. When we say int num, like the same name as that one, we're saying, hey, I want a different variable with the same name, and I'm just going to use it here, and I don't care about that other variable. Yeah.
How would you set the value of the instance variable num to that local variable?
I think we're going to get to that in the next section. Use the this keyword, so we'll see that. Perfect segue. So folks, in a non-static method, the keyword this refers to the current object. Boy, that sounds fun. I'll give you some specific examples of how we use this. Folks, generally it's a bad idea to use the same name in the constructor header or a method header as your instance variables. In this case, this is a good example of how to do it. Like I'm saying string first, string last, but the instance variables are first name and last name. So that all works great. If I wanted to use first name and last name in the header, and then I would have to put the this word in front of the instance variable. That's the one, the private string first name. This works fine. It just seems like more work. If you want to do it this way, you can. I like doing like string F and then just saying first name equals F and string L and then last name equals L. But if you like to see everything really clearly, this I guess is more clear. You know exactly what's coming in and you're setting the top level instance variable to that value. We can also use this to refer to the current actual object. So for example, I added a doit method to the frog class that uses this twice. Check this out. If you had a frog class and we added this method, you can say this.hop10. That tells it, hey, hop this frog, the one we're in, 10 spaces. And then it also can print it by saying print this. So anyway, this, when you just say print this, it's referring to the current object. Or you could call methods on that object. You don't have to. The funny thing is, I think this method would work fine if we just said hop 10 and print. I don't know how we could print it without this. Oh, we could just call the toString. But here you go. Java's funky. We're going to do more. Yeah, Walker.
Is printing just this the same as the toString method?
Yeah. Printing an object is the same as calling the toString method and printing that. So you have this is a problem from your multiple choice questions I'm going to ask you to do today, the B set for unit 5. So see we've got a contact, they got a name and a number, and there's this toString, and then there's this do something method, and it prints this. So this method just calls the toString and prints itself. It prints itself. It's referring to the object you just created. It calls the toString and then it prints it. It's just like if you were in another class and you said, you know, you created a contact named Hayes and then you printed Hayes. This is just doing it from inside itself, I guess. I don't know when you'd ever want to do this, except it's on the sample questions. So I thought I'd discuss it a bit rather than throw you to the wolves and then have you all go, what was this in the print thing? So I'm just showing you, it's not that big of a deal. It's kind of intuitive in a way. This means like this thing, the thing we're in, you know? I mean, it's okay. So what we're going to do, I think this is wrong in terms of the list. We're missing, we're doing an FRQ, but first we're going to do a broken class. I wrote a class that's broken. And